even if the guests can, and if we remember our studies, you would say that the day with two gospels, the second reading the gospel that was read from John is about Jesus himself before the resurrection. But it's read to us these days before the gospel is from the Acts, and it's still about Jesus in the church after the resurrection. It is good to understand that. So we have two gospels. The gospels do not tell us history. But there are a lot of historical things that we can see, recognize, and we could use. One thing we should realize is that second reading took place most likely less than 3 years before the first reading. So let's start with that. Started by saying the crowd said to Jesus. It was the anonymous people, so many people, the crowd. They were looking for a sign. What sign can you do? A sign coming from what Christ is doing, was supposed to do. They look for that. What is the answer? The sign that they are looking for is object, prayer. What they can invite, what they can gain. What is the answer of Jesus? The sign is the bread from heaven, given not by Moses, but by God himself. The sign is in himself, Jesus. He is the true bread. If we will continue reflecting on the gospel of St. John, he is the true bread. He said that very clearly. I am the bread of life. So it was starting to object. This is a person, eternal. Eternal because coming from God. It is not a question of having something. It is a question of being with someone. That is the sign. Maybe 3 years after, where is that sign? Stephen was talking this time to the people, the elders and the scribes, the very persons who eliminated, at least they thought, the sign who is Christ. Most likely Stephen never met Christ personally. But why is he the sign? First of all, by Christ. He did not mince his words. Use different people. He tells them who they were. He told them who they were. In uncircumcised hearts and ears, opposing always the Holy Spirit. Stephen, who did not know Christ physically and personally, was with Christ. He is the Christ. He is the continuation of Christ who is alive in the church. And why? Because he was filled with the Spirit. That's why he had no fear facing people, the elders, the scribes, those who put Christ to death, those who learned that Christ is risen, but they did not have the courage to accept that and to proclaim that. Stephen never met Jesus personally, but he was filled with the same Spirit. He was Christ by the Spirit. He became the sign. That's why the sign that was rejected is rejected again and again and again. The two readings, the good news, is not for us only to think about. Even before we think about it, St. Anselm was visited, we celebrated this as fetus, very intellectual. faith is, looks for understanding. Sometimes we do not understand. We fail to understand because faith is life. But if there is faith, then faith is not mere knowing things. It is being with the one we believe in. And it is in being with the bread of life, the sign. The sign always signifies something that we discover as we enter the sign. The sign becomes one of us. As we are assimilated into the sign enters us. Faith is that. We are now, first we let ourselves enter into the mystery. Sign, sacrament in Latin, mysterium in Greek, we enter into the mystery. And we allow the mystery to possess us, to completely penetrate us. And when we are one with the mystery, we understand more and more. It's different understood. Understood his identity with Christ. He also became sight. That's why he endured what Christ endured. And until now we know him, the first mark, the first witness. The first mystery is not the last. We are in a country that the more we understand their lives, the more we see how their faith makes them signs for people, for other people. And that is what we need in order to proclaim the good news, to show that we are happy being with Christ. That is our topic these days. And that is what we will proclaim to others, the experience of the sign, our experience of God. Even when that experience will lead us to difficult things, or maybe because we experience more, we understand better, because we are completely immersed even in that sign, the passion, the death, and the glorification. People will not understand that. People will first reject that it will be soul, as we have heard in the first reading. Soul was there. He became mortal. Most likely, when he saw, he witnessed the death of Stephen. And later he will have an experience of Christ. He will be transformed. Because he also entered into the sign. And he allowed the sign to completely engulf him. Amid that sign, can we say that we are like Stephen, so identified with Christ? Can we learn from our brothers and sisters in this land? In the Philippines, probably they don't too much our faith that they fail to understand its challenge, its meaning. Because we seek first to understand, and later on we feel that we can believe. In this country, and in this experience of the first Christians, they first believe. They first had experience of Christ. They saw like souls being transformed by themselves, being transformed by Christ. And then they understood and they announced. Not what they had thought about. As John says, what we have touched, what we have seen, him we proclaim. How can we do that? How can we be sure that we can be signs like Stephen, signs of the presence of Christ is alive? Maybe the only thing we will say, and we can say every moment of our life is, into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. When we surrender our spirit to God's spirit, then the Lord will take possession of us completely. And he will transform us as we again and again believe that the bread and wine is transformed into the body and blood of Christ. But we say, offers our spirit to His Spirit. He surrenders His completely to Him, no matter what the consequence may be. Then, we who believe will understand more and more. In this Mass and in every Mass, we have the joy of the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Yesterday, the bishops of us told us one of the reasons why they are able to endure the opposition. When they make opposition here, it's more like those who, all people who did not know God. The opposition in Stephen's time and Jesus are those who think they are with God, especially people like Saul. He thought that he had God completely. He forgot in the beginning. They forget that God is the one who should have them. We also think in the previous problem that we have God, we have the faith for almost 500 years. We forget that it's God who takes us for a purpose greater than ourselves. The Blessed Virgin Mary is an assurance for the church here, for their survival and their fidelity, the woman of faith. It is the same for us back home. We are called Pedro Amante de Maria, and we are very proud about that. Probably we have to understand by first believing like her what that means. How to be completely taken up by Christ, possessed by God, and then it will be the sign that she is, the sign that the church should be, the sign that Stephen and all the martyrs, including present martyrs in many countries like here, are trying to live. What is their strength? They only say, in the grace of God, I commend my spirit. May we be able to say the same.